In the compress data functions, we have compress data start time slash number and compress data start time slash end time. The data retrieved by these two functions is the same data. The only difference is the framing. In both instances, you specify a start time, but in the number function, start time number, you specify how many values you want to retrieve, and in the end time, you specify a given time range, and you will retrieve the values regardless of the number of values within that range. So for example, if I wanted to see the most recent 100 values, I would use the compressed data start time number function. If I wanted to review the last 3 hours worth of data, I would use the start time end time function. Here's a sample of a simple spreadsheet I've created with the headings tag name, start time, end time, and number of values. And I'd like to fill this sheet in with the data from these calls and show you exactly how this works. I'm going to start with the compressed data start time number function, and I'll click on that, which will bring up the dialog box, and I'll populate this with cell references because I have all of my numbers in here. For my number of values, I'll select 100, and I want to make sure that I show timestamps, and I'll click there and see that all the values are there. Now you'll notice that in the start time I said now minus 2 hours. However, I said I wanted the first 100 values. There clearly are not 100 values in this segment, so from 2 hours ago to now, so it will truncate the query at that point. If I were to go back far enough to have 100 values in the archive, then it would retrieve those. Remember, these are values that are actually in the archive. These are not interpolated values. One of the things about the compressed data start time number function is also the ability to go backwards in time. And if you put a number in this field, you can check backwards in time. However, if you use cell references for the field, you'll notice the backwards in time box is marked gray, so you can't use it. What you do in that case is you put a negative number in the field for the cell reference, and then instead of going forward in time, the system will go backward in time, the 100 values. So actually what we're seeing here, if we scroll down, are the most recent 100 values starting 2 hours ago. So if I wanted to get the most recent 100 values from now, I would simply change my start time to now and go a minus 100 number of values in the to go in the past, and I would gain the most recent 100 values.